Hey YouTube, welcome back to a brand new video. Today we're going to be discussing Animal Crossing Switch and when Nintendo will most likely reveal more about the new mainline game. So without further ado, let's get straight into today's video. So before we kick things off, just a quick announcement. As requested by a bunch of you guys, I finally got around to setting up a Discord server. I'm still working on adding a few new features, but the basics are there, so I'd really love for everyone to head over there and join in. We already have a bunch of people and discussions going on right now, and even a music bot that pretty much plays Animal Crossing music all day, which is really awesome. I'm planning on holding contests over there too in the coming weeks, and adding some more games, and generally building a community over there so we can discuss everything from Animal Crossing Switch to your favourite Nintendo titles. So yeah, the link is in the description and I hope to see you all over there soon. Now back to the point of this video, with the Nintendo Direct just last week having left some fans disappointed, I thought it'd be cool to take a quick overview of the Nintendo first party titles that will be releasing this year and try and figure out where that leaves Animal Crossing Switch. So right now, despite having just had an actual Nintendo Direct, the latest Nintendo rumour is that a Pokemon Direct is speculated in the next couple of weeks, with it expected to drop on National Pokemon Day. Pokemon Day is of course the 27th of February and celebrates the anniversary of the Japanese release of Pokemon Red and Pokemon Green. I'm not sure where this rumour originated, but it seems like a good time to announce the next generation of Pokemon. It's also not the first time Nintendo and the Pokemon Company used this anniversary to air a Pokemon Direct. Pokemon Sun and Moon trailers and gameplay were actually shown for the first time on Pokemon Day a few years ago. So as awesome as it would be to find out more about the next generation of Pokemon on the Nintendo Switch, it still leaves Animal Crossing fans in the land of the unknown. Now despite Pokemon Sun and Moon having a Direct so early, they still had November release dates in time for the holidays. So whether or not we see a Pokemon Direct within a couple of weeks this year, I'd say the holiday slot for a Nintendo release is most likely reserved for Pokemon Switch. Of course, this is still speculation, so let's take a look at some of the titles we know are coming. Super Mario Maker 2, one of the biggest surprises from the Nintendo Direct, is set to release this June. The game looks super awesome and perfect for the Switch, so I'd like to think that Animal Crossing wouldn't be scheduled for a release around the same time. Plus, in terms of game mechanics, this is nothing we haven't already seen for the most part, so I think Nintendo would happily release this without focusing on it too much at a conference like E3, which also happens in June. Now, Fire Emblem Three Houses is another first party title we know is coming. Although delayed slightly, Nintendo confirmed during the Direct that it will finally be released in July. With a huge section of the Direct dedicated to Fire Emblem gameplay, I would say this is the first party title we know the most about. So again, even if it was showcased at E3 in June for example, or covered in more depth in another Direct later in the year, I'm not sure Nintendo would share too much more before its launch in July. This of course leaves two huge first party titles launching at some point this year, Animal Crossing of course, and Luigi's Mansion 3. Luigi's Mansion 3 is a highly anticipated game and probably one of the most underrated games ever. Again, we've known Luigi's Mansion's coming for some time now, but still know very little about it other than what's been shown in a small trailer. This suggests Nintendo will reveal more in either a future Direct or of course E3, with a release towards the end of the year. And if anyone on Nintendo's marketing team has a sense of humour and wants to release during the spooky holiday season, October seems like the perfect time, by which point Fire Emblem hype has died down and Pokemon Switch hype hasn't started. So as a quick recap, in June and July we have Super Mario Maker 2 and Fire Emblem, with Luigi's Mansion 3 and Pokemon Switch with potential release dates in October and November. If we trust our judgement and that Nintendo wouldn't release two massive franchises at the same time, this leaves Animal Crossing Switch with an August or September release. Now if a Pokemon Direct does in fact air by the end of the month, that kind of removes any hope of hearing anything about Animal Crossing for several weeks. So my guess is, plain and simple, the reason Nintendo hasn't mentioned anything more than the initial announcement surrounding Animal Crossing Switch is because they're saving it for E3 in June. Given what we know now, this to me now makes the most sense. I mean, why wouldn't Nintendo showcase one of their biggest releases of the year at their biggest show of the year? They did this back in 2010 with New Leaf by showing off a 3DS trailer for the first time, so it's not unheard of to announce an Animal Crossing game at an event like E3, and if they did this with the Switch version, a release 2 or 3 months later seems reasonable. That gives them time to iron out the final details, build some hype, maybe show a dedicated Animal Crossing Direct, and of course launch the game. Plus, a summer release would probably be the most suitable season to launch what will no doubt be a beautiful looking game. So yeah, just food for thought really. Nintendo has become extremely unpredictable and do like to shake things up a bit, so who knows. As always, it's just a little bit of fun, but I would love to hear your thoughts. So yeah, that pretty much covers all the latest news surrounding Animal Crossing right now. As always, a special thank you to this channel's Patreon supporters, you guys rock, and don't forget to head over to the new Discord server and let us know when you think we'll hear more about Animal Crossing Switch. And of course, if you got this far in the video, please comment Pokemon, just to let me know you did, that'd be super awesome. And be sure to include if you think a Pokemon Direct will happen next week or not. Anyway, I hope you enjoyed this video and found it entertaining. Please be sure to leave a like if you did. Thanks for watching, I hope you have an amazing day, and I'll see you in my next video. Peace.